Hey everybody, welcome back. We have been getting quite a bit of information in regard to Modern Warfare 3 campaign, multiplayer, and yes, even zombies over the past 24 hours. And I gotta say, while I'm still cautiously optimistic, it has been pretty exciting to see the optimism coming from my content creator friends that had a chance to jump on and actually play Modern Warfare 3. It seems like a complete reversal of what Infinity Ward did this year in terms of speed and how quickly you can get back into the fight, slide canceling, reload canceling, all the stuff that people expect in Call of Duty is seemingly back. And on top of that, we're going to be seeing some new features, new pieces of equipment, and even a new way that perks and gear are set up along the way to allow us to customize our loadouts even more. So I want to talk about a few of these things that were revealed yesterday from those content creators that had a chance to get online and play. And starting with one of those features that I personally loved back in the day with Call of Duty Ghosts. And I'm not sure if y'all remember this, but the squad mates, where you could basically call in an additional squad mate and they would actually help you capture objectives and they would help you pick up tags. And it was essentially a solo player's best friend. Apparently that's going to be coming back in the form of a field upgrade, and I am stoked, especially when you remember that we're getting Dead Silence back, and I won't need to take that up in a field upgrade spot. So the new field upgrade that's coming through is called the ACS. When you throw it down, it will capture objectives for you without needing to be in the objective, and if you're in the objective with it, it will help you capture it even faster. This is the best case scenario for basically getting a squad mate without having something that can be lethal. It's not a streak, it's a field upgrade, it can be recharged. I'm very much so looking forward to this, mainly as a solo player. If I'm playing Domination and I need to jump on that B objective, that could inch out the last couple of seconds that I may need to capture that objective, as opposed to just getting taken off of it and the enemy take it over immediately. So I'm looking forward to that. But the ACS field upgrade can apparently work in twofold. So not only will it be assisting you in objective-based modes by capturing domination flags and things of that nature, but it can also be utilized in non-objective modes, giving those players who choose to run it an opportunity to hack enemy equipment. And I think that that's really cool. It's the best of both worlds. It gives you the opportunity as a solo player to have that backup if you need it, but it's also going to be nice to see how many of these on one flag at once could capture the flag. Is this going to change domination as we know it? Like, could five people throw this down on a domination flag, move directly to the C flag and get a triple cap because that thing is going to capture it instantaneously? Or can you throw five of them down and those same five players that just threw them down also stand on top of them, giving you essentially 10 people capturing an objective at once? That means you could probably capture an objective in like 1 second. I don't know if it's going to work that way, but it does sound pretty interesting. Another new field upgrade that was revealed last night via content creators is called the Comm Scrambler. This can keep any friendly player within the range of the Scrambler off the radar. And I think this is great, especially if you have a teammate that's not running Ghost or the equivalent of Ghost in MW3. And this could be really cool for those objective modes. Say someone is running the ACS while another team member runs the Comm Scrambler. This can be really effective for taking specific objectives. A brand new piece of lethal equipment was also revealed last night as well, called the Breach Drone. This is a lethal drone that flies a straight path until impact of an object or players. Does this sound familiar to you? The very first thing that I thought of was the TAR from Infinite Warfare, the Thrown Adhesive Rocket. This is a rocket-propelled system that delivers a sticky payload, and just for the sake of clarity, here's what it looks like in Infinite Warfare. This is one of my favorite pieces of equipment because it flies in a straight line, and if it attaches to a player, it's stuck to them. If it hits a wall, it will inevitably explode. But it really wasn't that easy to utilize because it's really easy to avoid. You see it coming towards you, all you have to do is step left or right and get out of the way, but for unsuspecting enemies and for those really lucky sticks or attaches, this can be a very fun piece of a lethal equipment to use. So I can't wait to see what it looks like, but just based off of the description itself, I would imagine it's going to work something along the lines of the TAR from Infinite Warfare. Speaking of explosions, a brand new streak was revealed yesterday called the Mosquito Drone. This is a drone that dive bombs at enemy players. I wouldn't really look too much into this. I'd imagine it's going to work pretty similar to a hunter-killer drone like we've seen in the past. Now, Part of me is really curious whether or not the Mosquito drone could be hacked, kind of similar to how we saw back in BO2, to then be utilized for your own team. Like, if you throw down the ACS field upgrade we just got done talking about in a non-objective game mode, would it be able to actually take down that Mosquito drone and turn it friendly before it dive bombs into you? I'm also curious if the Mosquito drone is going to have its counterpart that we have not seen since BO2, the swarm, because there could definitely be a mosquito swarm if there's a singular drone. I think that could look incredible updated in these newer titles as well. Leave your thoughts in the comments section below. There were also a couple of perks that were revealed as well. The first one is called the Signal Jammer. This will delay explosions from enemy lethal equipment. So things like the breach drone or Semtex grenades, frag grenades, things like that, it will all be delayed. This is going to work really well for specific pieces of equipment like proximity mines and claymores. I would imagine that's going to be returning in Modern Warfare 3 as well. So Signal Jammer might be a very good perk you want to utilize while playing specific modes. The next perk is called Detector. And I think that this could kind of be similar to High Alert based off of what it's been described as, but it detects when enemy lasers are pointing at you. So as we all know, with MW2, lasers have played a pretty prominent role in attaching them to your weapons to increase your aim down sight speed and tighten up hip fire spread. Sometimes they'll even help with your sprint to fire speed, but some of these lasers can get to the point where they're visible from the hip without needing to aim down sight or without being concealed. That means the enemies will see your lasers. So is this new detector perk going to allow you to detect those lasers that aren't visible by the human eye? I'm unsure at this point. It is very confusing, but at the same time, I'm interested in seeing how this gear slash perk system is going to work. We've already learned about the covert sneakers, which is essentially a return to form for Dead Silence. I'm curious just how many new perks there will be, and we're going to learn more information very soon. In fact, we're actually going to be getting our very first look at Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 gameplay during Gamescom opening night, and that's going to be happening on Tuesday at 8 p.m. CET, 2 p.m. Eastern, 11 a.m. Pacific time. I am looking forward to it. I think that it's probably just going to be campaign gameplay, but it's going to give us a really good understanding of, one, how good the game looks in comparison to Modern Warfare 2, and two, it will set the tone for whatever they're showing. I would imagine that the gameplay at first, they're most likely going to be showing the Gulag mission that we've been seeing so much of through promotional material. They may even give us our very first look at open combat missions at that point with like an open world and how we can actually tackle things. Kind of similar to Spec Ops missions that exist in the game, but a little bit more involved, I guess you could say. But I don't really think they're going to be showing much, if at anything, of multiplayer. If they do, though, I will definitely keep you posted. One thing that I can see them doing, especially since they're trying to capitalize as much as they can on nostalgia, is most likely recreate the Flag Runner trailer that we ended up getting with the reveal of Modern Warfare 2 multiplayer. It takes place on Favela. It's supposed to be uncut gameplay of Capture the Flag. I guess it all kind of rides on the fact of whether or not Capture the Flag would be there, but it would be pretty cool to see them reenact this again. We did see them do this before. Back when Favela was remade for Call of Duty Ghosts, they had a trailer called Blitz Runner. I even remember making a comparison video about 9 years ago when that happened. In fact, here's some footage of that if you want to see the comparison between the two. I think that it was a really good recreation of the original, and it was nice to see just exactly how big of a jump graphically it was at that point 9 years ago. Imagine what it's going to be now. 9 years later, Favela coming back in all of its glory on current gen and PC platforms. So it's going to be awesome. I'm actually looking forward to it quite a bit. So anyway, let me know your thoughts in the comments section below about everything we discussed here today. What do you think about the field upgrades and the perks and the streaks and the lethal pieces of equipment that we talked about? Are you getting excited for multiplayer? I gotta say that the information is exciting, but we gotta wait for the actual beta. I'm gonna wait for the beta before I give you my opinion on it. I haven't had a chance to play it. I haven't had a chance to see it, so I'm not entirely sure what it's gonna be. Anyway, that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Drop a like if you enjoyed. Subscribe for more coming very soon, and don't forget to ring the bell icon. Join that notification squad, and I'll see you all on the next one. Peace.